I started developing my writing and started recording, and also dabbled in beat making as well. So that's really when it kicked off, when I was around 14. Up to that point, I had been writing and performing at like talent shows and things like this on and off, but I got a little more serious when I turned 14 in regards to actively doing things and putting things together myself. My big influences were Public Enemy, De La Soul, Arrested Development, Rakim, Eric B. KRS-One is probably singly the biggest influence on me. I'm also influenced a lot by jazz artists as well, and soul artists, and then rock too. I'm also influenced by rock music as well. But it was the lyricism and the consciousness that these hip-hop artists were on that really influenced me the most. Yeah, I was born and raised Muslim, and I try and live the best of my ability, conform to, I'm using that word, conform, but be consistent with these principles and teachings. So it's natural for me to talk about that in my writing, because that's just part of my everyday life. You know, it's not just a terminology or vocabulary that I use to sound relevant, you know, or, oh, everyone's saying Allah in the rap, I'm gonna say it too, or something like that, you know. You know, I consider myself a practicing Muslim, so of course it's natural that I would relate what has to do with me and my writing. Politics is unintentionally a very active main point within the type of hip hop that I do and my writing. That was just always been a natural part of who I am. Even if you ask friends of mine, they'll be like, yeah, I always have political and social talks with Ibrahim about, you know, whatever, you know. And I always try and keep myself in tune with what's going on in the world, no matter if it was in the Philippines, if it's in the United States, or if it's in Europe or Africa. You know, I try to stay up on the condition of people, you know? So transcribing that in my music and in my writing is a very natural thing, which I did. My whole focus right now actually is what I'm doing immediately, but in hopes of building something. And what I'm building is, I just want to build a legacy of putting out great music. Fortunately, I'm in a situation right now where I can put all my focus on making the music I want to make. And that's why I really like this situation. In terms of signing to a major label, doesn't really excite me. Would I do it? Yeah, it depends, you know, if all the conditions are right, you know, but I just wouldn't jump at the first thing that shows its face. Like, can't flash a bunch of money in front of me and expect me to jump. I'm not, and compromise who I am. But if it's a situation where I don't have to compromise, you know, my identity, my core values and principles, hey, I'm definitely open to talk about that possibility.
Your perception of the world, missing the blessings of life. Every boy and girl, woman and man, filled with light. But you have to look inside to make the flame ignite. Set up your aim and make a change tonight. Everyone wants happiness.